Hi there, welcome you to ExpoHub channel, and today we are into exercise number 35 and we are going to learn something very interesting, and that could be one of your interview questions. So let's get started. In case you are new to our channel, please let me tell you how our channel contents are helping our subscribers, and here are a couple of messages. Also, how do you take the maximum benefit of our channel? To take maximum benefit of our channel, all you have to do is click on the playlist, click on the videos, and try to check how many contents we have created till date and how we have organized our playlist as per the chapter in the UiPath Academy. So you can take benefit of all this contents. So with that, let's get back to our exercise today. So our exercise is a tricky question. Okay, so here the question for you is, how will you remove multiple columns from a data table? So the task for you is, how will you remove multiple columns from a data table, and the condition here, without using remove data column activity. So there is an activity called remove data column activity. Without using that, how can you remove multiple columns? So for example, this is the data table given to you. So you can create any data table of your choice. If this is given to you, you have been asked to remove the product ID and cost, and write the output containing only product name. So the final output should only contain product name. Okay, first of all, if like this table is given to me, if I will use a remove data column, there will be a problem. First thing, I have to use remove data column multiple times, because remove data column is going to remove column and I have to specify that column index number or column name. Right, so it is going to delete one by one and I have to use multiple times. First problem. Second problem, let's say first column you are deleting column A, so it will delete. Next time you want to delete, so 0, 1, 2, if you have mentioned index number 2, it will throw you an error, because first time it has already deleted and there is no more 2, it is 0 and 1 now. So those kind of technical problems will also appear when I am going for a remove data column. Okay, I am going to show you that. So what is the answer? Okay, what is the answer for this? So we are going to see that, in case you are aware what to do. Very pretty simple answer, but again, this could be a tricky question if you are not aware. Okay, so let's get started. After completing the exercise, please do mark yes, and please do subscribe to our channel in case you are a new visitor. Okay, so with that, let's go back to studio. So first thing, in an Excel file, I have this data, product ID, product name, cost. You can create any table, some 3-4 columns you can create, right? So after that, all I am doing is reading this and storing in data table 1. Okay, so I was talking about remove data column. So there is a data table activity called remove data table, remove data column. So using remove data column, there is a problem. Okay, remove data column, there is a problem. So what is the problem? I'll tell you. So here, data table name is DT1. Column index is, let's say, first one I want to remove, so 0. So let me copy paste. Let me try again. Okay, and the last one I want to remove, so 0, 1, 2. Okay, so I am removing both of it. Now there will be a problem. So if I run this, so 0 means this, 2 means this, 0, 1, 2. So I want to remove 2. So simple way, you will mention 0, 2, but there is a technical problem. What is the technical problem? Can you tell me? So the technical problem is, if I run it now, there will be an error thrown. What is the error? Because my table, specifically my table, has got 3 columns, only 3 columns. So first one it has removed. So after removing from 3 minus 1, you have only 2 rows. So 0 and 1 index is left. You are mentioning 2 to delete, index number 2. It is saying remove data column message cannot find column 2. So are you understanding? After first one it has run, it has removed already 1. So there is no more 3 columns, it has only 2 columns. So this index number is supposed to be 1. So this is a technical problem. Again, you have to come over here and make it 1 so that the final output would come. But again, imagine if you have a huge number of columns, then it will be a big problem. Okay, so this may not be a appropriate way to do it. So what is the appropriate way? Okay, so the appropriate, yes, you guessed it right, the appropriate way to use or to achieve this possibly will be filter data table. Okay, so using this filter data table, I can pretty well utilize. So I'll click on filter wizard, and here my input data table DT1, even output data table is DT1. I'm not creating a new one. Okay, same thing, both of the things I'm keeping. And here row filtering mode. So I'm not, for example, product ID is equal to this, or cost is less than 1,000 rupees. So you can put all these columns to keep the specific rows or remove those specific rows. So I'm not dealing with rows now. I want to just remove columns. So what I will do, I'll click on output column, click on remove, and mention I want to remove zero. So it is going to act at a time, and I want to remove the column number 2. Okay, all right. So the final output will be written in the sheet 3. So let's check it. Okay, so our sheet 3 is blank. So it is reading from sheet 1, and only the product name it's supposed to write in sheet 3. So let's run it and see how it works. Getting it. So it's a very simple answer. So if this answer is thrown at you, then you would say, I'm not going to use remove data column anyways because of such technical issues. So what I can do is, because there are multiple columns, so I'll be using a filter data table activity and filter out. Okay, so this is the pretty good example for you to learn. So if I open this up, okay, and go to sheet 3, you can see only the product name has been written. So this could be one of the answer. If this is asked in your interview, so you know the answer. All right, so thank you so much for watching. Please do like, please do subscribe to our channel, and please do share with your friends. Thank you so much. We'll meet again in our next video. Bye bye.